Hibernate Enverse is a popular library that automates the creation of an audit log. As I've shown in previous videos and articles, it logs all write operations performed using your entity classes in an audit log and provides a flexible API to query that data from that log. Based on these videos, I got recently asked if Hibernate Enverse provides any support for DTO projections. And that's what I will talk about in this video. You will find the links to my previous videos about Enverse in the description. Hi, I'm Torben Jansen with another video about building incredibly efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. In general, fetching DTO objects is a useful approach if you want to implement more complex use cases than just showing the latest changes on a specific business object. DTO projections provide the benefit that you can adjust them to each use case's specific needs and that you avoid the overhead of managed entity objects. This makes them the optimal projection for all read-only operations. Enverse Query API is very flexible. You can use it to define complex queries that work on the data valid at a certain point in time or on all changes performed on a business object. You can also define different kinds of projections. Unfortunately, I didn't find any direct support for DTO projections, but the Query API is flexible enough to define a use case-specific projection that includes Scala values from different entities. In the next step, you can then instantiate your DTO objects. Let's take a look at an example. In this video, I will use a chess game and a chess player entity. Both classes are simple entity classes that are annotated with Enverse audited annotation. Besides that, there isn't anything special about these classes. The primary keys get generated by Hibernate's default sequence, and I rely on the default mapping for the other basic attributes. Between these two entity classes, I modeled two bidirectional many-to-one, one-to-many associations to persist who played the white and who played the black pieces. When doing that, you should make sure to set the fetch type of the many-to-one association to lazy to avoid performance problems. Let's use these two entities to fetch a chess game DTO projection from the audit log that only includes the date and the tournament's round when the game was played, and the first and last name of both players. As explained in my article about Hibernate Enverse Query API, you can look at your audit log from a horizontal or vertical perspective, define custom projections, and create complex where clauses. I use all of that here to get the ID of the chess game, the round and date when it was played, and the first and last name of both players. And don't worry, the code might look complex, but I will explain all of it. Let's start at the first line. To define a query using Hibernate Enverse Query API, you need to get an instance of an audit reader. Using that reader, you can then define a horizontal or vertical query. In this example, I call the forEntitiesAddRevision method to create a horizontal query. It works on the data that was valid at a certain point in time. A typical use case is to retrieve the data that was valid after we drew the first round. Then I call the add method to define the where clause. In this example, it's very simple. I want to get information about a specific game, so my where clause only compares the audited record's primary key value with the primary key of the game I'm searching for. After this is done, I define the projection by calling the addProjection method for every entity attribute we want to retrieve. The interesting part here is the traversal of associations. You can do that using the methods traverseRelation and up. By calling the traverseRelation method, I traverse the player white association from the chess game entity to the associated chess player entity. After doing that, I call the addProjection method twice and reference the first name and last name attribute of the chess player entity. In the next step, I first navigate back to the chess game entity before I can traverse the association to the second player. You can do that by calling the up method. I traverse one step back within your graph of entities. So in this example, it navigates from the chess player back to the chess game. From the chess game, we can then traverse the player black association to the second player who played the black pieces and add their name to the projection. This query returns an object array with 6 fields that contain the round and date of the game, the first and last name of the player with the white pieces, and the first and last name of the player with the black pieces. In the next step, we can use this information to instantiate and initialize a chess game DTO object. DTO projections are the perfect fit for read operations. They enable you to model a data structure that's the perfect fit for the business operations you want to perform, and they require less overhead than an entity projection. Unfortunately, Hibernate NRAS doesn't provide any direct support for DTO projections, but its query API is flexible and powerful enough to define Scala projections containing attributes from multiple entity objects. The Scala projection is returned as an object array. You could, of course, use it directly in your business code, but code that works on an object array is hard to read and maintain. I therefore recommend mapping the object array immediately to a DTO object. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!